I'm really excited to finally be able to go back out in the world, but I think I've kind of forgotten how to talk to people. We all know that chemistry pub trivia is the best conversation starter. People love that stuff. And fortunately, I have someone who's really great at it that's gonna help me practice. Hello. Hello. Okay, teach me how to talk to people at a pub. Guess how many bubbles are in this beer? 10,000? Not even close.
11,000.
Nope.
12,000?
All right, calm down. When you pour a glass of beer, bubbles mostly made of carbon dioxide start coming out of solution and rising to the surface. So to figure out how many bubbles were in a glass of beer, researchers measured the amount of carbon dioxide dissolved in that beer just after it was poured into a tilted glass. Got it. Using that value, they figured out that dissolved CO2 would spontaneously come together to form streams of bubbles wherever crevices and cavities in the glass were more than 1.4 microns wide. So, like 13,000? They estimated that there could be between 200,000 and 2 million bubbles released before a half pint of lager would go flat. Amazing. Keep talking. See this pretty foam? Okay, so we're switching to hard alcohol. The foam is actually egg whites, and egg whites are filled with proteins that act as surfactants. One end of a surfactant is hydrophilic, or attracted to water, and the other is hydrophobic. It hates water. So if you add egg whites to your cocktail and then shake it up, the hydrophobic parts of the surfactant stay in the air that gets mixed in, while the hydrophilic bits stick to the liquid in the drink. The surfactants surround these tiny air bubbles, stopping the smaller bubbles from just combining to form larger bubbles that could eventually escape. And voila, you have foam. Is that, who is that for? I got you another drink. Don't worry, it's not alcoholic. Are you a Shirley Temple fan? She was kind of before my time. Shirley Temple, the drink. What do you think grenadine is made from?
I don't know, I guess I really never thought about
it. Wrong! Not cherries. It's actually pomegranate juice reduced with sugar and then dyed red.
Ooh, pomegranate.
Fun fact, did you know that during Prohibition, a lot of people would go blind from drinking alcohol? That's actually not fun at all. Want to talk about something less depressing?
Yeah, definitely.
Great. On to food. Try this.
Ooh, spicy.
Yeah, that's jalapeno, which has a lot of a compound called capsaicin.
Yep, that's spicy.
Capsaicin will bind to proteins on pain receptor cells in a lot of places, including your mouth. And that triggers a response telling you you're in pain. It's the same signal that's sent if you touch a burning stove or skin your knee. If you want to get rid of that spice, which it looks like you do, keep in mind that capsaicin is non-polar, like oil. So something polar, like the beer you're holding, isn't gonna do much. You need something with molecules that are nonpolar, like this ice cream here. Try this. There are a lot of molecules in there, like fats and proteins, that are nonpolar.
But I'm
Yeah, I know you're lactose intolerant. Don't worry, it's made with almond milk. And sweet stuff will actually help too. Not entirely clear why, but researchers think that it'll overwhelm your taste buds with that sweet sensation, masking the burn. I actually made a video about this last year. Okay, let's move on. Giving you jalapeno chips was kind of mean of me. I have a peace offering.
Offering accepted.
Did you know that chemists have actually ID'd odor compounds in pretzel crusts? A team found 22 compounds and made a pretzel perfume out of it.
Now that would be a conversation starter if you wore it to a bar.
It really, really would. So they removed each individual molecule to figure out the ones that are essential for the amazing pretzel smell. It came down to two in particular. 2-acetyl-1-pyrrolene, which has a roasted smell, and 4-hydroxy-2,5-dimethyl-3,2-H-furanone, which has a caramel smell.
Got it. 4-hydroxy-2,5-dimethyl-3,2-H-furanone.
Okay, last food. Hope you're a pickle fan. Actually, yeah, big pickle fan. Great. So pickling can actually be done in a couple of ways. You can either soak the food that you're trying to pickle, like that cucumber there, in something acidic, like vinegar, or you can let it ferment and it'll create vinegar on its own. Pretty awesome.
And delicious.
Agreed. All right, that's all I got for you.
I think I'm ready.
You're not, but bring your notes, and if you start to feel awkward, hit him with some chemistry trivia. You'll do great. You'll do fine. And if all else fails, remember, hydrogen bonding is always applicable.